just leaving Etterley, where I moored up for the night because I was absolutely soaked to the skin. The torrential downpour of rain. That's an interesting stretch of the canal. It's heavily shuttered both sides, and there's a lovely recreational, peaceful area here on the right hand side. It's a dinky little narrow boat, look.
Tunnels aren't my favourite, I have to say.
They're not my bloody favourite either, and it doesn't say much about them in here.
But as the Sanskrit says, do one thing and scares you to death.
It's all very well, but is it good for my institution sometimes? No.
So this is quite interesting, the roads going along by the side of the canal, and they've got a brand new housing estate over there. But amongst that brand new housing estate, I don't know if you can catch it actually, there's an old Tudor house, beamed house. Look at that, looks fantastic. Now in the middle of a housing estate.
Oh, here he is. Hello,
oh,
again.
Yeah.
Got another helper now.
Yeah, I believe
I think
so.
He is.
Thank you. Windlass is down there by the lock gate. There's a massive great chunk on the right hand side on this bridge that's missing, where boats have hit it, and it's going to hit the aerial, I think. It's really low, mind your head. It's an interesting little bridge. That's it. Different heights on that bridge. The first part of it's very low, not the internet aerial down. Big factory complex over there with a big tall chimney.
Thank you.
Yeah, that factory is a massive great salt works. You can see the bags of salt stacked up there, look. Over there. So, it's the salt we're buying for the water softener. Thank you.
There's another runway to come up, so it's easy for you.
Thank you.
That's got to be an old pub on the left-hand side there, look. Probably built for the canal in its day, now derelict. The Kinderton Arms. I think it's used as office. See, the grass is sweet there, the swans are up on the bank eating it. Exploring Middlewich. So this is the junction of the Rochdale Canal. Fantastic old lock keeper's cottage over there on the left. Surrounded by modern housing now. So then they're just coming down and joining the Trent and Mersey at the junction of the Middlewich Canal Centre. And there's a boat just joining the Rochdale Canal. As I say, surrounded by modern housing now. It's actually the Wardle Canal and Junction, which is one of Britain's shortest canals, measuring just 35 metres in length. Wardle Lock, known by many as Maureen's Lock, who lived in the lock keeper's cottage that is behind us. I'll put some links in the description. There's too much there to explain, but it's all very interesting. So they're coming up from the Trent Mersey, and they're currently on the Wardour Canal. And they're running to catch a bus. So this is the junction of the Wardour Canal onto the Trent Mersey Canal at Middlewich, which is famous salt-making town since Roman times. To this day, they still manufacture salt here. Doris doesn't have to stoop down. She can come through there without ducking her head. Bloody midget. Okay, King's Lock, Middlewich, Trent and Mersey Canal. So we're walking up the towpath from where we'd moored towards the town centre, and that's Middlewich Wharf directly in front. There's a really busy little section here. There's lots of boating activity going on. Salt's been produced in Middlewich since Roman times. 200 years ago, when the canals arrived, they brought coal to fuel the steam-powered machinery. Link in the description. Middlewich Wharf seems to be a centre for hire boats, although there's loads of them moored up. Larry's Hairdressers. Looking at the state of it, I shouldn't think they've had many customers. Probably they're all bald like me. So the Narrowboat pub, no longer in use. On a really busy street through Middlewich. Yet another one bit the dust. You can rent that for £100 a week. And low ingoings. As I say, brave man take on a pub these days. There's the church on what is now a really busy road. In the days of horse and cart, that would have been a nice rural spot, elevated position, surrounded by traffic now. Some nice roadside bedding plants over there, lovely pink colours. And Lidl's literally just round the corner. Supplies. Oh, that's the big lock. Pub and dining. Right on the canal side. And that's the back of it that backs onto the canal. Got a nice terrace up the top there. All nicely ironed pillars and platform. And also there's the Newton Brewery Inn that has a back garden that goes down to the canal. Drop anchor. Live sport. Well, there's a derelict house there, right on the canal. Prime piece of real estate, really. One wonders what's going to happen to places like that. So this is an old warehouse loft building right next to the derelict house. So I guess it was all connected with the canal. There, and I've answered my own question. Warehouse and wharf Leadsmithy Street. Again, a lot of information there. I'll put a link in the description. So this is a flight of locks we've got to do tomorrow, which is to by the Anderson Boat Hire Company. So the three locks area, the sign's actually saying the navigation becomes complicated at the three locks. Here in the centre of Middlewich, in the three locks, the fall between the top and bottom lock is around 23 foot. Links in the description. And between the top lock and the second lock down is quite an extreme bend you have to negotiate. Haven't travelled far today, we've just come down to Middlewich from Etterley. As you can probably hear, we're moored up right next to a really busy road that runs parallel to the canal. But what an interesting canal area of Middlewich is. It's got lots of history. It's famous for its salt making since Roman times apparently, and there is still salt making going on here today past a massive great factory on the way, which will be in the video. We've had a walk around and a good look. It is very interesting. Lots of history, which is too much to cover. I'll put links in the description for anybody that's interested in researching it further. All in all, very enjoyable. Once again, thanks for watching. Hope it's not too boring. See you later, alligator.